SpaceX is developing Starship at its Starbase facility in Boca Chica Beach, located in the southernmost tip of Texas, where engineers have flown multiple spacecraft prototypes into altitudes under 20 kilometers. In the past 3 years, the facility has rapidly grown into a rocket factory, with giant stainless steel Starship prototypes, vehicle assembly buildings, and the first Super Heavy-class Starship orbital launch tower is near completion. The 400-foot-tall launch tower is equipped with giant clamp-like arms, called Mechazilla, designed to stack the 160-foot-tall Starship atop the 230-foot-tall Super Heavy rocket. It will also catch the stainless steel vehicles as each descends to the launch mount soon after propelling the payload to orbit. Mechazilla will enable the company to recover the launch vehicle quickly to relaunch it in under an hour. Fast reusability will enable SpaceX to conduct cost-effective spaceflights. Starbase could have another orbital launch tower in 2022 to support back-to-back Starship operations, according to a graphic SpaceX submitted to U.S. Federal Aviation Administration, document in a previous statement by company leaders. On Friday, December 3, SpaceX founder Elon Musk shared that SpaceX will also build a Starship orbital launch tower at NASA Kennedy Space Center's Historic Launch Complex 39A. Construction of Starship orbital launch pad at the Cape has begun, Musk tweeted. 39A is hallowed spaceflight ground, no place more deserving of a Starship launch pad. We'll have similar, but improved, ground systems and tower to Starbase, he shared in a follow-up tweet. SpaceX already had plans to build a Starship launch site at Florida's Space Coast. It previously submitted a Starship launch site proposal to NASA in 2019. Starship is the massive, next-generation rocket SpaceX is developing to launch cargo and people on missions to the Moon and Mars. The company had previously started some work on a Starship-specific launch pad on the grounds of Launch Complex 39A at NASA's Kennedy Space Center, which SpaceX leases from the agency to launch its Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy rockets. But, since builders have poured concrete for the foundation of the Starship pad in late 2019, the location has largely remained dormant. NASA, in a statement to CNBC, confirmed that SpaceX is within the rights of their lease agreement to make launch infrastructure improvements within the boundaries of the pad. The agency also confirmed that NASA is not providing funding for the Starship launch pad and deferred to SpaceX on the project's scope, cost, and timeline. The space agency performed an environmental assessment of the plan in 2019, and gave SpaceX permission to begin work within the LC-39A site. But the agency said that, approval is only to build at this time, with authorization for launches and landings requiring a separate approval process. Tom Engler, Director of Planning and Development at NASA's Kennedy Space Center, told CNBC that he thinks the SpaceX plan is really exciting. Before the company leased the complex, it was previously used to launch Saturn V rockets for Apollo missions, as well as space shuttle missions. If you look at the history of the launch pad, this is probably right in line with how it was meant to be used, Engler said. To us, it's really just kind of an reaffirmation of the thought process of why that pad was built to begin with. When SpaceX began Starship development in earnest 2 years ago, the company started building rocket prototypes both nearby the NASA complex and at its private facility in Boca Chica, Texas. The company later pivoted to focus on work at the Boca Chica site, which is nicknamed Starbase, and has since conducted Starship test flights and more from the Texas location. Last month, Musk said that SpaceX will, hopefully launch, the first Starship prototype to orbit in January or February from Texas, the company's next major step in developing the rocket. That test is pending regulatory approval, as SpaceX needs a launch license from the Federal Aviation Administration for the mission, with the federal agency expecting to complete a key environmental assessment by the end of this year. Musk's tweet on Friday marks the renewal of work on the Florida launch site for the Mammoth rocket, as he pushes SpaceX to perform as many as a dozen Starship test flights next year. His construction announcement also comes as SpaceX works to resolve a crisis with production of the Raptor engines that power Starship rockets, which Musk disclosed in an email to employees the day after Thanksgiving. Musk's email described a dire situation, warning of a genuine risk of bankruptcy for SpaceX if the company is not flying Starship rockets regularly by the end of 2022. In a brief update earlier this week, Musk tweeted that issues with the Raptor engines are getting fixed, but did not provide more details on the problem or solution. Starship manufacturing and testing operations are currently centered at Starbase, SpaceX's facility in South Texas, near the Gulf Coast village of Boca Chica. The site has hosted test flights of multiple prototype vehicles over the past few years. The highest of those test jaunts reached just 7.8 miles, 12.5 kilometers into the Texas sky. But a much bigger leap will happen soon, if all goes according to plan, the first orbital test flight of a Starship vehicle. Musk has said that SpaceX aims to launch this flight from Starbase in January or February, provided an environmental assessment being performed by the U.S. Federal Aviation Administration, wraps up by the end of the year as expected. In 2014, SpaceX signed a 20-year lease agreement with NASA, that lets the company use Pad 39A, the jumping-off point for all but two of the agency's crewed Apollo missions, and most of its space shuttle flights. SpaceX already launches its Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy rockets from the site, but the giant Starship requires new infrastructure. Launch Complex 39A has historic significance, because it is the same location, from where Apollo NASA astronauts lifted off atop the Saturn V rocket, on a voyage to set foot on the lunar surface. Pad 39A also supported space shuttle missions up until its retirement in 2011. SpaceX is leasing the launch complex. It is from where Falcon 9 launches crew and cargo flights to the International Space Station. The company already has permission to make modifications at Pad 39A to support future Starship missions. A launch pad at the Kennedy Space Center will likely support crewed missions to the Moon, under NASA's Artemis program that aims to create a sustainable presence on our closest celestial neighbor. NASA selected SpaceX to develop a lunar-optimized Starship human landing system, to land the first woman and next man on the Moon by 2025. SpaceX is working on a tight schedule to have a space-ready launch system by then. Musk previously said he is confident that Starship will successfully conduct an orbital flight in 2022. Engineers at the Starbase facility are working to prepare the prototypes that will conduct the first orbital flight test at Boca Chica. Stainless steel prototypes Starship SN20 and Super Heavy Booster 4 are designed to test the launch system and provide engineers with vital data to improve the spacecraft. Musk says they target to conduct the orbital flight sometime in January or February. The company is still pending regulatory approval from the FAA. The administration targets to complete an environmental assessment of Starbase by December 31st to ensure safe spaceflight activities. Once complete, SpaceX will be able to apply for an orbital Starship flight license. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, make sure to subscribe. If you have any crazy ideas about what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we'll see if we can get to it. So thanks again for watching and goodbye.